Hello everyone, welcome to Modern History Lecture Series. This is the fourth part of the topic, The Decline of Mughal Empire. In the last video, that is the part 3 of this topic, we discussed about Muhammad Shah, Ahmad Shah and the invasions of Nadir Shah and Ahmad Shah Abdali. We discussed about the invasion of Ahmad Shah Abdali till his fourth invasion. And in this video, we will start with the discussion of the rule of Alamgir II. As we discussed about the last Mughal emperor, that is Ahmad Shah, that he was deposed off the throne by his own wazir. His wazir got a proposal passed in the court of deposing the emperor. And after Ahmad Shah, Jahandar Shah's son Azizuddin Alamgir II, his real name was Azizuddin, was raised to the throne with the name of Alamgir II. He was very weak ruler and he was just like a puppet in the hands of his own wazir, Ghaziuddin Imadul Mulk. During the time of Alamgir, the overall condition of the administration of the defense was so bad that it led to various uprisings and revolts. Even the army, the soldiers, they were not paid salaries. They were dying of hunger, because of which it led to the intra-revolt between the Mughal army itself. Relation between Emperor Alamgir and his wazir Imadul Mulk was so bad, they were not cordial, that wazir got emperor murdered and even deposed his body in the Yamuna river in 1759. And during the time of Alamgir rule, it was the peak time of Maratha expansion, and it was just looking evident that the next mighty power after the Mughals will be Marathas. Invasions of Ahmad Shah Abdali also increased during his rule, and during his time period, that is from 1754 to 1759, Abdali attacked for the fifth time. Abdali invasion during the Alamgir Reign. It was the fifth invasion in 1757, and Abdali had already attacked for the fourth time. Four times he had attacked, and this was the fifth invasion. And after fourth invasion, Abdali had appointed Najibuddaula as the Mir Bakshi. He had appointed him, and he Najibuddaula remained in Delhi as an agent of Ahmad Shah Abdali. But when Abdali returned after the departure of Abdali, Najibuddaula was forced to leave Delhi, and in place of him, Ahmad Bangesh was appointed as Mir Bakshi in his place. Also, Sarhind and Lahore fell into the hands of Marathas in 1758. As I told you in the last slide, that Maratha power was increasing and they were capturing the northern India. So Sarhind and Lahore, that fell into the hand of Marathas in 1758. Abdali was upset of this interference, so that is why he sent Jahan Khan to the Punjab, but he was defeated. And after that, Abdali, after the defeat of Jahan Khan, he himself attacked, and that attack was for the fifth time. And as Marathas' power and influence was increasing, but they were not able to stand against the Abdali forces. And Marathas, they were forced to withdraw from the Lahore, Multan and Sarhind, which they had captured. So the result was that at the end of 1759, Punjab was once again brought under the control of Ahmad Shah Abdali. He again controlled overall Punjab, as the Marathas were capturing the areas of Punjab. But Abdali defeated the Marathas, and at the end of 1759, Punjab was once again brought under the control of Ahmad Shah Abdali. Alamgir II was murdered by his own wazir, and after that, the next successor of Mughal Empire was Shah Alam II. At the time of his father's death, he was in Patna, where he took the title of Alamgir II, and he declared himself as the emperor on 22nd December 1759. Because of the invasions of Ahmad Shah Abdali, overall condition of the Mughal Empire was shattering, and also it was very clear in front of everyone, it was just like an open book, that the condition of Mughal Empire was very bad, even economically. If we take economically, if we take financially and army wise, in all aspects, their defense, everything was just shattering. Because of overall uprisings, revolt, and the weakened condition of Mughal Empire due to Abdali invasion, Shah Alam didn't dare to enter Delhi even after assuming the title, even after assuming the throne for about 12 years. He didn't dare to enter Delhi for about 12 years. And he could only enter Delhi with the help of Marathas, with the aid of Marathas in 1772. So when did he declare himself the emperor? That is in 1759. And when he entered into Delhi, that is in 1772. So that is for 12 years he was not able to enter Delhi. He didn't dare to enter Delhi and sat on his throne. So in 1772, he entered Delhi with the aid of Marathas and sat on his throne for the first time in 1772. During the time of Shah Alam, Abdali attacked for the sixth time, and already he had attacked for the fifth time during the rule of Alamgir, and during the time of Shah Alam, he attacked for the sixth time. As all the later Mughals, they were not real ruler, they were nominal ruler, they were under the control of their ministers, nobles. Similarly, Shah Alam was also just like a puppet at the hands of his own ministers, at the hands of even Marathas. And now we can see from the point that he was able to sat on his own throne with the help of Marathas. So he was just like a puppet. He used to follow their advices, and even the Britishers' influence was increasing that time. So he remained puppet at the hands of ministers, Marathas and Britishers. Shah Alam participated in Battle of Buxar. This Battle of Buxar is very important. This is very decisive battle, and we will discuss about this battle when we will discuss about rise of Bengal state. And in this battle, he was in opposition to English. Battle of Buxar took place in 1764, and Shah Alam was in opposition to English, and he was with Bengal Nawab Mir Kazim. But Britishers won this battle, and in 1765, after the defeat in Battle of Buxar, Shah Alam had to sign a treaty with the Britishers. And according to this treaty, he had to give the Subedari of Bengal, Bihar, Odisha, all the three important places, Bengal, Bihar and Odisha, to the Britishers. And in return, Britishers promised him to give 26 lakh per annum as a pension. So he became the pensioner of the Britishers. And overall, if we see the rule of Shah Alam, it was full of tragedies and obstacles. Invasion of Abdali, Third Battle of Panipat, Battle of Buxar, so many tragedies, so many defeats he faced during his rule. In 1788, he was blinded by Ghulam Kadir, but because of again the aid of Marathas, he was released and he was again sat on his throne, and Ghulam Kadir was hanged till death. He was executed. And later on in 1803, Britishers, they annexed Delhi, and Shah Alam had to live rest of his life as a pensioner from the Britisher. And after 3 years, in 1806, Shah Alam died. So whole of his life was full of tragedies and obstacles. One of the happening which took place during the time of Shah Alam's rule was the Third Battle of Panipat. According to few sources, the date was 14 January 1761. So the year was 1761, and it took place during the rule of Shah Alam II. And this battle was between Ahmad Shah Abdali and Marathas. As we discussed, in the fifth invasion of Ahmad Shah Abdali, he had captured whole of the Punjab and even captured Lahore, Multan, Sarhind, which was earlier being captured by Marathas. So Abdali captured the whole Marathas. They were defeated during that invasion. Again, the Peshwas, we will discuss about the Peshwas when we will discuss about the Marathas in our coming videos. So the Peshwas, they took up the challenge, or the Marathas, they took up the challenge of Ahmad Shah Abdali, and they sent their leaders Sadashiv Rao Bhau to the north in 1760. In the Battle of Panipat, Marathas leader were Sadashiv Rao Bhau and Vishwas Rao, and artilleries were under Ibrahim Khan Gardi. So, on 14 January 1761, battle took place between the two sides, Ahmad Shah Abdali and Marathas. Marathas, they fought very bravely, but they were not able to defeat Abdali. The result was that they were defeated. And both the leaders of Marathas, Vishwas Rao, who was son of Peshwa, and Sadashiv Rao, they both died in the battle. According to few historians, it was also been said that in Maharashtra, there was rarely a family been left who had not lost their family member in this battle. After the battle, after the third battle of Panipat, Shah Alam was declared emperor, Nizamuddaula as Mir Bakshi and Imadul Mulk as Wazir. And if we account about the overall battle of Panipat, the only success which Marathas could get was the entry into Delhi. Because they could enter into Delhi when Abdali was busy campaigning in Doab. Because after that they were not able to sustain. They had no friend in Delhi. Rajput, Jats, they were not helping Marathas. So they were alone in north. Because of scarcity of food, horses, they could not sustain in the war. And this led to their defeat in the third battle of Panipat. During the rule of Shah Alam, Abdali again invaded in 1764. And the main reason behind these invasion and the rest of the invasion, 6th and 7th invasion, they were to crush Sikh. And according to few sources, Abdali also invaded for 8th time, but all these invasions were in the area of Punjab. As the Sikh power was increasing in Punjab, they captured considerable property and they also killed Khwaja Abid, who was the Afghan governor of Lahore. And the main reason, as I told you, that Abdali invasion was to punish Sikhs. And he stayed for a very short time during this invasion because he had to go back to Afghanistan as there were so many troubles taking place over there in his absence. Revolts were taking place at Afghanistan. So because of that, he was not able to stay for long in Punjab. This was the 6th invasion which took place in 1764. And again, Abdali invaded for the 7th time. That was in March 67. The reason was same. That was to crush the Sikh. But again, he failed in crushing Sikhs. He had to retreat back because of, again, the revolts of the soldiers and intra-revolt in Afghanistan area. And Abdali, he had to left India and Sikh captured Lahore and the areas of Punjab, Mahaja and Central Punjab again. And however, he was able to capture few of the areas of Peshawar later on. But overall, during this invasion, he was not able to crush Sikhs. And as I again told you that according to few sources, it has been said that he again invaded for the 8th time, but that was only in this area and the reason was to crush Sikh only. And these invasions of Ahmad Shah Abdali, they were also one of the reason for the decline of the Mughal Empire. And we will discuss about all these reasons which really enhanced the degeneration of Mughal Empire later on. And one of the reason was these invasions of Ahmad Shah Abdali. After death of Shah Alam II in 1806, the next successor of Mughal rule was Akbar II, and he ruled from 1806 till 1837. He was just a nominal ruler and had a little de facto power. That is, in real, he had very less power because the influence of Britishers was increasing. He had a very little real power, that is, he had little de facto power due to the increasing British control of India through the East India Company. At that time, Britishers, they were controlling over India through their company, East India Company. And because of his treatment, because he was getting pension from East India Company as like his father, because of his treatment, he appointed Ram Mohan Roy, who was a Bengali reformer, to appeal against his treatment. And he sent him as an ambassador to Britain. And here one important question which can be asked, that who gave the title of Raja to Bengali reformer Ram Mohan Roy. So the title was conferred by Akbar II. Akbar II conferred title of Raja on Ram Mohan Roy. So he was mere a pensioner of British rule. He used to get a pension from British just like his father, and his overall power was very less. He was just a nominal ruler, and his power only spread in the four walls of Red Fort in Delhi. And he died in 1837. Throughout his life, he used to get pension. He was just a pensioner. The next ruler after Akbar II was Bahadur Shah II. He ruled from 1837 till 1857. And he was the last Mughal emperor. He was son of Akbar II. Bahadur Shah was also just a nominal ruler. And his full name as popularly been known as Bahadur Shah Zafar. Now, he was a very great, he was a prolific Urdu poet and a ghazal writer. And he used to write these poets and poetry and ghazals with the name Zafar. So that is why this name, this title Zafar is used with Bahadur Shah. And he is known as Bahadur Shah Zafar. And as the Mughal power had shrinked to such an extent, it was limited in the four walls of the Red Fort. So Bahadur Shah Zafar presided over the Mughal Empire that barely extended beyond the Delhi Red Fort. And the main event which took place during his rule was the revolt of 1857. That was the first war of independence, and Bahadur Shah participated in this revolt of 1857. Although he himself was very old, but he was announced as the leader of the revolt, as the Emperor of India during this revolt. But soon he was captured by Major William Hudson during the revolt in Humayun Tomb, which is in Delhi, where he had taken shrine. And after capturing him, he was exiled to Rangoon, which was a place in Burma. It's a place in Burma, British controlled Burma that time. And all the male members of his family, they were killed by the company forces. Surviving members of Mughal dynasty, they were imprisoned, or many of them were exiled. So he was the last Mughal ruler. And we discussed about all the later Mughals after Aurangzeb. We discussed from Bahadur Shah I, who assumed the throne after Aurangzeb, till Bahadur Shah II, who was the last Mughal emperor. And we discussed about various mistakes which were committed by them. These all later Mughals, they were so incapable that various mistakes they committed, which led to the fast degeneration of Mughal empire. Now next, let's discuss about the various causes of decline of Mughal empire. That what can be the causes? If we see the overview of all the things which happened during these years after the Aurangzeb, starting from Aurangzeb itself, that what were the causes of decline of Mughal empire. And if we start from Aurangzeb policies itself was not apt. His few policies also led to the start of the decline of Mughal empire. And one of his policy was the expansion policy of Aurangzeb. During the rule of Aurangzeb, he expanded his empire to such an extent that he could not control it effectively. It was just like a balloon, inflated balloon. And he could not have an effective control over such a vastness, over such a vast spreaded empire. And its vastness only tended to weaken the center. There was no means of communication, effective communication in those days. That when he stayed at Deccan, he tried to control the Deccan area, he was not able to control the north area. When he tried to control the north area, he was not able to control the Deccan area. So overall, this expansion policy was also one of the cause of decline of Mughal empire. Another policy of Aurangzeb was the religious policy. He was very orthodox ruler. We had discussed about Aurangzeb in our first video of the decline of Mughal empire, the first part of that topic, and we discussed that he was very religious in his policies. He tried to restore the Islamic character of the state, and he had abandoned the policy of pluralism, because he used to believe that his empire was an Islamic empire and it was being disturbed by Akbar and his successors, like his father even. And he abandoned the policy of pluralism, where all the religious groups, they are allowed to strive together. So he abandoned this religious policy of Aurangzeb. And we also discussed that he also tried to destroy few temples. He restored the tax of jizya. So these religious policies were so controversial, it led to the unrest in the state. Then the continuous war in the Deccan had drained a lot of the empire treasury, royal treasury, and these war meant a great financial drain on the treasury, and this led to the decline of the Mughal empire, because overall the finances and army is very important, and all the time army was busy in fighting wars in the Deccan area. So this also was one of the reason of decline of Mughal empire. Another reason was the policy of aggressive imperialism. We had discussed that Aurangzeb was authoritarian ruler, and the conquest of Muslim kingdoms of Bijapur and Golconda, it removed the strongest local check over the Maratha activities, because Marathas, their influence started rising and left them free to organize resistance against the Mughal imperialism. Another main reason for the causes of decline of Mughal empire, they were the later Mughals, and we have discussed about them a lot, the weak successors of Aurangzeb. Another reason for the cause of decline of Mughal empire was the court factions. There were so many groups in the Mughal empire. We have discussed about these groupism of Irani, Turani, Hindustani and Afghani group in the Mughal court, and all these groups, they were against one another to such a point that they used to conspire against each other. And this court faction, one of the reason for the decline of Mughal empire. These groups, they used to upset the peace of the country, and even in case of the foreign dangers, they used to oppose among themselves only. They used to have intra rivalries only and never formed a united front against the foreign invaders. And for example, when we discussed about Nadir Shah invasion, we discussed that the personal interest of Nizamul Mulk and Sadat Khan, they conspired with Nadir Shah, and they, in that way, they harmed their own state. The next reason for the cause of decline of Mughal empire was the rise of the Marathas. Marathas, they were rising, they were becoming next effective power after the Mughals, and Mughals, they were not able to check the rising power of Marathas. And we discussed in our last policy of Aurangzeb only, that the aggressive nature of the Aurangzeb, in which he conquered the area of Bijapur and Golconda, and these Bijapur and Golconda area, they were trying to control the Marathas empire. But as Aurangzeb had expanded his empire, that he had no strong local check against these Marathas, and their increasing influence was defeated in the third battle of Panipat, when they fought against Ahmad Shah Abdali. And though they were defeated, they were not successful in laying the foundation of a stable empire in India, but they certainly played a very great role in bringing about the degeneration of Mughal empire. Military is also a backbone of an empire, and Mughal empire was very weak in this case even during the later time. That is, cause of military weakness was the reason of their decline. And the main reason of the Mughal military system was that it was based on the feudal system. There was Mansabdari system. Military was also very weak in the Mughal empire, and it was the main reason of their weakness were, like, they were, number one, they were on the feudal basis, they were the common soldiers, they used to look upon Mansabdar at their chief, as their chief, not as an officer. Also, their fighting capacity was not very good, and they could not stand in front of the guerrilla tactics tactics of the Marathas. Their artillery was very crude, it was very raw and ineffective, and they could not stand in front of British arms even. And one of the reasons for their military weakness was that the soldiers, they were usually drawn from the Central Asia and collected by the captains of companies who supplied men to anyone able to pay for them. And these soldiers' main interest was to earn money. And money played a very important role. If the leader of such army changed their sights, as they used to be continuous plotting and betraying, so whole army used to side with the leader. And the Mughal viceroy used to employ such troops. They were under the fear of their desertion. So the military was not very loyal. Next reason, we have discussed these two in very detail, that invasions of Nadir Shah and Ahmad Shah, and we have discussed that how they used to plunder the state and how they used to disturb the overall peace of the country. And because of their invasion, the weakness of Mughal Empire was so open that even Britishers, they were able to got to know that the Mughal Empire was declining. One of the reason was economic bankruptcy, that was deteriorating state of economy because of the continuous wars and the lavish lifestyle of the emperor, later Mughals, worsening economic and financial condition, which was visible in 17th century. Aurangzeb, long wars in Dakkan, and under the later Mughals, the financial condition was further deteriorated. Numerous war of succession and emperor, they emptied the royal treasury to such an extent that even the salaries of soldiers could not be paid regularly. And then one of the reason was the advent of Europeans. Many European companies, they came to India, Portuguese, Dutch, Danish, and all were aware of the degenerating state of Mughal Empire. And with the weakness of Mughal central authority in the 18th century, European companies also acted as warlords, and they profited from the confused times of the state. Mughal aristocrats, they were so behind their time. They used to import European luxury articles, very expensive articles, but no one thought of purchasing a printing press. Everywhere in the European country, industrial revolution was taking place during the later Mughals' time. But at that time, the Indian people, they were far behind. The Indian states, they were far behind in the race of civilization. Thus, these inherent weakness of the Mughal Empire led to the advent of various European companies to India. Another reason was the degeneration of Mughal nobles. The later nobles, they were so busy in living their luxurious life that they were not at all interested in establishing a stable state. The nobles like Behram Khan during the time of Akbar, Muzaffar Khan, Abdul Rahim Khane Khana, Mahabat Khan, Asaf Khan, they were no longer available for the services of the state. The new nobles under the later Mughals, they used to rival among themselves, and they were just mere flatterers of the emperor. So these were the few causes of the decline of Mughal Empire. So here we come to an end of our topic, the first topic, that is the decline of Mughal Empire. In our next video, we will discuss about few of very important questions which can come in entrance exam or which have come in entrance exam. In meanwhile, you can also write few of the causes if you know in the comment section. After discussing the questions from this topic, we will discuss our next topic, the rise of new autonomous state. Thank you very much.